So when it comes to Bethesda Studios really knows how to make quality games, whether we're talking about the Elder Scrolls games, the Fallout games, or the Wolfenstein games, they definitely know how to make quality AAA games. However, a lot of their AAA games do have bugs and glitches, whereas other developers out there don't put as many bugs and glitches that Bethesda does in their games. And some people out there will actually tell you the reason you like a lot of these Bethesda games is because they do have that charm by having these bugs and glitches in this game. You get used to them, and that's part of Bethesda, and you just accept it. But honestly, if you ask me, I think that's a little bit silly going around saying, "Yes, I accept these bugs and glitches. That's what give these games their charm, and that's why I like Bethesda Studios. They keep putting a lot of bugs and glitches in their video games, even decades after they've been already a game developer." But honestly, that is unacceptable, especially if you compare them to other devs out in the gaming industry. I just think they lack in comparison when it comes to the polish of their games. I think the polish of their games are not up to par with other game studios. But like I said, as a whole, they do make quality products, and you do have to give them credit where credit is due. And a lot of their games are beloved games throughout gaming history, like the Skyrim, or like Fallout 3, or the Fallout series as a whole. Their games are quality games. Now, you may remember last year, the whole fiasco, late 2018, the whole fiasco with Fallout 76. Fallout 76 was just definitely a big, massive disaster, but it was a massive disaster for good reason. And then a lot of people right now are definitely losing faith in Bethesda, and they're really worried about their upcoming Elder Scrolls game. They did announce Elder Scrolls, I think, back in E3 2018, and we knew we were going to be getting some type of Elder Scrolls game, since it's been so many years since Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim has come out on the market, and I think it is time for a new Elder Scrolls type experience, and we are going to be getting a new experience. But a lot of people are up in the air about that, because after Fallout 76, not only was the game a disaster, but also Bethesda lied to us in a lot of aspects that a lot of people are just having a bad taste in their mouth for Bethesda. And a lot of people don't know if they should trust Bethesda after Fallout 76. Should they continue to support Bethesda after Fallout 76? But they have every good reason and right to not to be worried about their upcoming projects, and to be worried about that company. It pretty much turned out that the company was a good company pretty much prior to Fallout 76, but now since Fallout 76 comes up, people look at Bethesda in a whole new different light, and that is definitely not a good thing. Bethesda should definitely be worried about people being mad at Bethesda for that, and they really need to clean their act up, because if the next game comes out and it's horribly bad from Bethesda, then people just aren't going to trust Bethesda ever again, and then Bethesda could end up in some very massive problems, and that should not happen to a company that was once great, now that's kind of lacking when it comes to the quality of their games, especially Fallout 76. But it looks like actually Bethesda is back in the news this time, and Bethesda is actually back in the news for all the wrong reasons, not the right reasons. So you would think after the whole Fallout 76 fiasco, they would want to turn this thing around by doing a lot of good gaming practices in the gaming industry to get gamers' faith back and get people trusting Bethesda again. But nope, they just can't do things right, and they really seem like they're trashing their own reputation. It's their fault, it's nobody else's fault. So if Bethesda ends up going broke, which most likely they're not going to go broke, and if they do go broke, it won't be now, it would be years down the road. But either way, if they do, something does happen to them, they only have themselves to blame. Let's talk about this new thing that's going on with Bethesda and why a lot of gamers are absolutely upset about the choices Bethesda is actually making in mid-2019. First of all, there's a new game coming out by Bethesda Studios. This game is called Wolfenstein. Now, it's not your normal-sized Wolfenstein experience. It's much more of a smaller Wolfenstein experience. The game is called Wolfenstein Youngblood, and Wolfenstein Youngblood is pretty much coming to all major platforms, even the Nintendo Switch. You guys know Wolfenstein 2 did come out on the Nintendo Switch as well, and apparently that was a very well-received game when it comes to the Nintendo Switch version of that game. Sure, it wasn't the best-playing version of Wolfenstein 2, but just taking in consideration it ran as well as it did on the Nintendo Switch, that was a very good decision from Bethesda to port it over to the Nintendo Switch. And I don't think many people estimated that game to actually run on the Nintendo Switch as well as it did as well. So two thumbs up to Bethesda to actually allowing that project. Overall, their last game that came out in 2017, but the Wolfenstein 2 game, the Wolfenstein 2 game was flat out a very good game. It just sucks a lot of the game A lot of people did not pick up Wolfenstein 2, actually. Wolfenstein 2 was actually one game that absolutely sold like trash, and it just had really bad numbers. That game pretty much bombed. I don't think it was the worst-selling game of all time, of course not, but it definitely was a game that, for some reason, even though it was an amazing game, people just did not like the game, and most people did not pick up the game. Even when it was ported over to the Nintendo Switch, people did not buy the game there as well. Overall, people just did not buy the game. Well, it looks like Wolfenstein Youngblood, like I said, is coming to every platform out there, including the Nintendo Switch, and I guess Bethesda was like, Wolfenstein 2 sold extremely bad, even on the Nintendo Switch, so let's go ahead and put Wolfenstein Youngblood on every platform. But Wolfenstein 2, talking about the game itself, is a game that's much more smaller experience compared to some of the other Wolfenstein games, especially if you compare it to their last one, Wolfenstein 2. This game is definitely a much more smaller game than Wolfenstein. Wolfenstein Youngblood is definitely much more of a smaller game than Wolfenstein 2 when you compare it, and they've done this in the past with some of their other Wolfenstein games, so this is not like the first time we're seeing a much more smaller Wolfenstein experience, but it's nice, I guess, they don't even care about the sales figures of Wolfenstein 2, that they're going to go ahead and put Wolfenstein Youngblood on every platform possible, including the Nintendo Switch. However, there is one problem with the Switch version, especially if you're going to be buying this game physical. The biggest problem we have with Wolfenstein 2 on the Nintendo Switch, especially if you're buying it physical, is the fact that when you go into a normal retail setting and you buy the actual game physical like you would expect, you're not going to actually be getting the actual game physically. You're actually going to be getting a stinking download code in the box for Wolfenstein Youngblood when you buy it at local retailers, or even if you buy it online from things like Amazon brand new, you're going to be getting a code in the box. And after everything Bethesda had did with the Fallout series and Fallout 76, this cannot help their image. This definitely has to hurt their image as a whole, because why would you ever want to do something like this? This is definitely anti-consumer. This is definitely not pro-consumer. And this is just absolutely ridiculous that they're going to be releasing a game physical and putting a download code in the box. Why aren't they putting an actual cartridge for the Nintendo Switch version in the box? When you look at the other versions of the game, whether we're talking about the Xbox or the PS4, they're definitely going to be putting a disc in the box. So it's not like they're doing this to all versions of the game that are physical versions. If they were doing that to all versions of the game, that might be a different story, and this story might not even matter as much as it do. But to exclude the Nintendo Switch version and only put a digital code in the box when you buy the game physical is outright disturbing, and it's outright kind of stupid that they're actually doing this. A lot of people may have their theories about this. One theory is, well, Wolfenstein 2 bombed hard, so that's why the game's not going to be coming to Nintendo Switch physical. It's actually going to be only a digital code inside the box when you buy the game physical. But I just don't buy that story at all, because every platform bombed. So why are they making sure that there's no download? Why are they making sure that there's no physical cart in the Nintendo Switch version when the other versions of Wolfenstein Youngblood that are coming out are going to have a physical copy in the box? It just really does not make sense to me how they're excluding the Nintendo Switch, but the other versions are getting an actual disc in the box when you buy the disc, so they are getting some form of physical media. So I'm not going to buy that story that, oh, Wolfenstein 2 sold bad, so that's why we're excluding the Nintendo Switch version. A lot of people are saying, well, the reason that it could be a digital code inside the box is because media for the Nintendo Switch is definitely very expensive for a lot of companies to buy, and especially if you're buying a big Switch cart, it may cost you a lot of money. That is true, and that's why you see a lot of companies like, for instance, Capcom, on a lot of their games that are Nintendo Switch games, they don't put the whole entire game on the physical Switch cart. They actually leave a lot of it off, and they tell you to download the rest of it onto your micro SD card. But I don't think it would be that expensive to put Wolfenstein 2 on a physical cart. You do have to take in consideration Bethesda is a very well-off company. I'm assuming they have millions in the bank. I'm assuming it won't cost them that much, but maybe after they've seen Wolfenstein 2 fell so hard on every single platform, they may be like, well, we're trying to save some money. Maybe the Nintendo Switch owner specifically won't go out and buy this game. I don't know how well the Nintendo Switch version of Wolfenstein 2 actually sold. I'm assuming it sold less than the other platforms in general, whether we're talking about a PS4 or Xbox One, because it did come out a year later, so maybe a lot of people who were going to play the game already played the game. And then on top of that, if you were going to buy the game, maybe people saw the performance problems that the game had, because yes, it did have performance problems since it was the weakest version of Wolfenstein 2, and maybe since it just bombed bad, they were like, no, let's give Nintendo Switch owners no physical version in the box. But honestly, if you ask me, this news freaking blows my mind how freaking ridiculous this is, that a game comes out physical and there's only a digital code in the box, no physical media whatsoever. So what's the point of buying this physical? Honestly, if you ask me, there is no freaking point to buy this game physical. You should not go out and buy it physical. Actually, I don't even know why they're actually even going to do this. That's just a waste of money on their part, having to buy all these Nintendo Switch boxes, buying all the paperwork, game art to put on the box. Overall, it just does not make sense from a business standpoint to actually do this. They should just put it on the Nintendo eShop. Why are they doing that? It's kind of like a backstab to gamers, if you think about it, because a gamer goes to a store, they're expecting a physical game in the box, and it turns out there's no physical game in the box. And honestly, it's just a waste of time buying it as well, because it will take up space, of course, in your house or in your home. And why do that when there's nothing actually in the box? It just boggles my mind. And then on top of that, this is also bad for the environment. If you're a person that really cares about the environment, this is definitely a waste for the environment, because you're buying a box and you're buying a piece of paper with the artwork on it inside the box or whatever the case may be, and you're not getting anything. So you're just pretty much having a stinking plastic cover and a plastic paper inside of it for the box art or whatever on you. And that's pretty much stupid, and it's just bad for the environment. It's bad for the trees, of course. It's bad for plastic overall. It's just a stupid idea. Why are they even doing this? I just do not understand. They're really trying to hurt their reputation more than they're trying to help their reputation at this point. And after all Bethesda has done, you would think they would really want to clean up their act after Fallout 76, but nope, they're definitely hurting their image here by doing this stunt on the Nintendo Switch, and this is downright disgusting. And Bethesda, we're losing faith and losing hope on your studios, because you're doing so many bad decisions when it comes to gaming. Why? Oh my god, Bethesda, seriously, I just do not understand why they're doing this, and no one will actually know this. And honestly, you may be sitting here thinking to yourself, this is the first game that's actually come out, that's actually been a game where you don't get the digital version, where you don't get the actual physical media in the box, but that's not the truth. You guys remember when Cuphead came out, they did do a physical version of that game, but indeed, Microsoft and whatever studio made that game said, nope, we're not going to put any disc in the box as well. So when you bought Cuphead brand new for physical, you did get a digital code in the actual box. You just got a stinking box, and that was freaking unacceptable as well. I almost want to pull my hair out on this story and pull it freaking hard, that this is so freaking stupid that Bethesda cannot get their act together. So now you know, when you buy Wolfenstein Youngblood on the Nintendo Switch, you're actually not going to be getting any type of physical media in the box. You're going to be getting a download code. So just don't waste your time at retails. Actually, anybody who does decide to buy Wolfenstein Youngblood on the Nintendo Switch, they really need to boycott the game and just do not buy the game at store shelves. So all those copies are going to be sitting on store shelves, so they won't pull this stunt again. But then there's those clueless gamers that maybe haven't heard this story or just don't care. They still want some representation on their game shelf, and I get why you would want to do that. Some representation is better, but I think for most gamers out there, they really want to have a physical game in the actual box. That's the whole point of buying physical. They want to own the game itself. They don't want it digital, because going back to digital, you don't own the game outright. So that kind of stinks. You go to a store and you buy a physical, but then you get a digital, then you're not actually owning the game. You have to worry about pretty much them lending you a license. That's how it always is when you buy games digital. It does suck. So basically what I'm saying is, if for some reason the eShop goes down or they remove the game from the shop, you can no longer play the game, because, well, it's Bethesda and they didn't want to give you a physical game in the box so you can keep playing it forever. So you better hope they don't remove it from the store so that you still have the copy of Wolfenstein Youngblood. And yeah, that's pretty much the whole story there. Anyway, guys, this is Wayne from MyTech News, signing out.